Welcome to section 8. And if you've managed to get through this course up until this point, congratulations. You did it, and I'm proud of you. And there's one more section to go. And in this section, we're focusing on four things. The first being the admin dashboard, where we can view all of the users and our data. Then we're going to look at optimizations to see if we can improve parts of our app. We'll also talk about third-party integrations for payments and transactional email. And lastly, we'll close up with how to deploy your app to live. This section is action-packed and will hopefully answer a lot of your burning questions as well. So let's get to it. So I'm logged in as an admin, and here is my admin dashboard. We're going to upload some CSV data so that we have more realistic data to play with. And that will obviously populate this chart with something that looks more presentable and more like the real thing. We're going to have a users tab, and this is just an overview of the particular users of which you can search and then also filter by either a company or a candidate. The job section will be similar. Here are all of our jobs, and we can filter by company. Here is Orbit. So after we finish building these pages, which will only take us a few lessons, we'll be digging into the optimization part. So jumping around on each page, looking to see how we could either improve the user experience, refactor some of our workflows to make them simpler or more modular. We'll be looking at things like backend workflows, what they are, when they should be used, things like scheduling workflows to run later on. And then we are going to be talking about payments. And the vast majority of internet businesses and bubble apps will be using what's called Stripe. And you just have to look at some of these logos down here to see what kind of companies are also using Stripe. And the nice thing about Stripe is so many bubblers are using it. The forum is awash with lots of information about how to integrate payments either through the API or the way I would do it, using one of the plugins available to us. And at Bubble, we've created a really useful plugin that is so straightforward to use. You can get up and running within a matter of hours, okay? Then we'll be talking about transactional email. And there are lots of options here. SendGrid is one option. They've been around for possibly the longest. And for SendGrid, there is a plugin available, actually quite a few different plugins, depending how you want to integrate with SendGrid. But there are many other transactional email services available in the plugin section, and we'll have a look at that a little bit later. And then lastly, we'll look at deployment and the various things that we need to complete before deployment, one of them being a custom domain. And this is a very straightforward process, which we'll talk about shortly. Okay, so this is going to be a very varied section, as you can see, and I think we should get started right away.